It's like on fire. It's on fire, and then it's gonna be fried. All right. Deadline is March 31st for picks.
Just miss that. Pick that up. Bye. Well, good morning. Force Hill.
Good morning, Retrievers.
How's everybody doing?
Rockin'.
Miss Cook.
Fabulous.
Happy Friday.
Happy Friday.
Miss Munchko.
Happy Friday. Woo! We are ready and rocking.
Excellent, excellent, excellent. We wanted to show you and remind you a couple things from our Facebook page there. You got links to your picture day snaps for the yearbook. All of our videos and shows are always reposted there, as well as some pictures of some of the activities going on around school. So if you miss something, that's the place to find it again. And you can get to the web, the Facebook page from our website, as well as, I guess Facebook. Sort of talked myself into a corner there. Hershey Park tickets are going on. These things are due. April 9th, and they're good for a whole year. So they're good all the way through next year, and there's a big old deep discount.
That is a huge discount.
Yes.
Huge discount.
We got a lot of stuff in the works as we're getting ready to move towards 4 days a week and plan for end of the year academic celebrations. And our partnership with the PTA makes all of that happen and all of that more special than it otherwise would be. So we thank them and thank everybody who's supporting our PTA. Before we move on to today's show, there's just a couple of updates. Families, you know, students will begin to attend 4 days a week next week. That's doubling the class sizes in our teachers' rooms. We're still synchronous with the children at home, but you know, that operational demand of working the room and making sure everybody's okay and doing what they're supposed to be doing will result in another bit of educational and instructional balance. The teachers are going to find their way through that, each grade level team, based upon what they're teaching, how many kids are in the room, how many kids they've got at home. We'll fine tune that to their own specifications, and they'll keep you posted along the way. But nobody's getting left behind and nobody's getting forgotten, and we're really looking forward to this next step. One more step towards normalcy. Right, Ms. Munchko?
Absolutely. Woohoo! We are ready.
Couple other thoughts on 4 days a week. Next week, our car riders, please note, you know, that line is going to get longer. So at any time you can reconsider the bus, you could take a look at the bus locator on hcps.org. Give a phone call or send in a note with your child if there's going to be a change. Give us a call at the school. And all the drivers are stopping at all the stops anyway, so they'll be able to get the kids right away. So go ahead and consider that. If you are still going to remain a car rider when you pick up, please note that we do have some handicapped plates that need to park in the handicapped spot over there. So I know people are hanging out and waiting for the buses to go, but if you could just get around that flagpole so that the handicapped spaces are open, that would be great. Please remember, families, to charge up those laptops. We do not have tons and tons of sockets in the building, nor do we have lots and lots of power strips, and the kids can't really cluster around the power strip and plug in either. So please make sure those laptops are powered up. And Earbuds too always help with calmness and sanity in the classroom, prevents echoes and all of that kind of stuff. So if you can send them in with some earbuds, that'd be great as well. Let's see. All right, so we are looking forward to the big show happening on Monday. Next week, we're closed early, 3 hours early, Thursday. And then all instructions closed next Friday as the spring break begins. So we are on the cusp of it and excited to hopefully see some tulips and some sunshine come out. Right, Miss Cook?
Yes, I love sunshine.
We thrive on it.
Yes.
Yep.
Yeah. It's like medicine for me.
Amen.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So families do consider, our teachers are thoughtfully considering and helping as best they can keep those laptops safe and damage-free. We've only had a few, but we do need to know. I mean, the Office of Technology makes us send these nasty letters to parents, which, you know, may or may not be charged. Really, we're only, if something happens here, only if a child was really negligent, thoughtless, or it's just stopped following the directions of the teacher. But right, other than that, you know, everybody's taking good care of them. The teachers are considering how the numbers of kids are doubling. So how the laptops will be used and when and where will all be, balanced out by the teachers so that they can deliver the best instruction possible for your kids. All right. That's me right now. All the little principal stuff out of the way. So, Ms. Munchko, what about some birthdays?
We have some birthdays in the house. First off, to the lovely Risha Mishra.
Happy birthday, Risha.
Her birthday, happy birthday, was on the 24th, and she shares the same birthday with the famous American magician, Harry Houdini.
No way.
I know. And if we get to a talent show, I just want to say his world famous escapes from bonds of every sort, locks, handcuffs, straitjackets, sealed chests. I mean, just amazing. But something
that was doing disappear.
Where'd he go?
Did he disappear?
I wonder if Mr. Hamilton went to the Library of Congress because he sent one of the most complete and valuable sets of Library of Magic to the Library of Congress. Did you know that?
I did not know that.
So wicked, super wicked cool.
But I
could go on and on. And Miss Risha Mishra, you share the same birthday as Peyton Manning, one of NFL's best quarterbacks with Super Bowl wins from two different teams, the Colts in 2007 and Denver Broncos in 2016. So how cool is that, Miss Risha? Okay. and the other birthday girl, her birthday was yesterday, is the lovely Miss Stover.
Happy birthday,
Miss Stover. She's not only a WVU sister fan, but she also shares the same birthday with the Queen of Soul, 15-time Grammy winner, first female to be inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and lifetime achievement Grammy, and a Kennedy Center honoree, none other than Aretha Respect Franklin. Woohoo!
That's pretty cool. And this is, in case you didn't know, this is Miss Stover's spirit animal.
Oh, that's cool. I did not know that.
She's a fearsome special educator.
That's wicked cool. Actually, I got a joke about that at one of his friends later on. And something else in common with her birthday also, and was this week as well, was it was Maryland Day. So I just want to mention that. Maryland Day was...
That's why I'm wearing my tie, because I've learned all sorts of things about Maryland since I moved out here from Tucson.
And same here from New York. I'm still learning things about Maryland. For example, the reason it's on March 25th is it commemorates when the settlers disembarked from two sailing ships, the Ark and the Dove. And their purpose was not to, discover new lands, but to settle them. So that was back March 25th, 1634. And I have just a couple quick trivias if we just got a moment. Are you ready, Miss Cook? You got your
people. I'm ready.
Oh, I know
okay.
more than she
Wait,
does.
I got it. Just, I want to say this before you start. Neither of us, or none of the three of us, are born Marylanders. All three of us are from different states.
Is that crazy?
Right.
Yeah. And there. I'm going to say I'm still going to beat the pants off of Mr. Hamilton right now.
There's all no right. way.
Okay, yes. get your buzzer okay. ready. I mean, buzzer right. ready.
I'm just going to stop the answer. I don't have a buzzer. I'm saying.
All right. Let's start with an easy one. The state flower.
That
was easy.
It's a Venus flytrap.
All right. The state bird.
The oil. I mean, oil. Oil.
All right, there you go. All right.
It's
more challenging. Okay. The state dog.
Chesapeake Bay Retriever.
It's easy.
Yeah, good girl. All right, this one's a tricky one, and I know because giddy up. The state horse.
Horse?
That was easy.
It's actually the thoroughbred horse.
Oh.
You know, cousin Preakness.
I still know that one.
Well, second jewel of the Triple Crown. That's okay. You'll never forget it now, Miss Cook. All right. Now listen carefully because people get it mixed up. All right, the team sport, Maryland's team sport. Good girl. All
that
right.
Easy.
Now, the
Sherry Hearing.
Mr. Hamilton, you got this one. The individual state sport, Mr. Hamilton.
Jousting.
Individual state sport.
That was
I got it. I already said it.
All right. Well, now this one, if you get it, then you guys, I will give you, get the rest of the pie. This one, it's an archaic Italian motto for Maryland.
What's the matter?
Yes. Oh, okay. I'll give you that. But the translation, they had to change it a little bit because it was the meaning was manly deeds, womanly words. But that's been changed. It's been changed to strong deeds, gentle words. Okay, I think that's more current and relevant.
Well, you know, Maryland can't be cool with everything, you know.
Yeah, but I thought you did a good job. And one more thing before I hand off there. Instead of doing all the sports, the brackets are a hot mess and everything. But I'm going to give a shout out to the men's team, Loyola of the Chicago Ramblers. They were like really low in the brackets. I'm thinking, oh. What was I thinking? Why did I not put that higher up in my brackets? Because of Sister Jean Dolores Schmidt. She is the chaplain of the men's basketball team. She's 101. She
wow.
missed last year's, because of the COVID, we didn't have the Final Four thing. So here she is. I'm looking at her. They should not have been placed up to the Sweet 16, but because of her, they're going further and further and further.
Nice.
So she's an amazing woman. One more little thing. She's going to retire when she was, you got me started, when she was 75, she's going to retire. But they begged her to stay, and they begged her to stay on, and she became the helper for the athletes to maintain their grades, because if you don't have good grades, you can't play the sports. So that was back when she was 75 to retire, and now she's 101.
Whoa.
Amazing.
I hope so I'm still working hard when I'm
Loyola of Chicago.
That's great. She was like a flapper back then in the 20s.
She all found right, her voice. Hey, she found her voice.
I don't know where we're at now. I'm lost.
News of the week. Hey,
oh, that's
Ms.
it, right?
Green, I got one from Miss Green. She'd like to compliment the entire kindergarten for their manners. They say please and thank you, and when they ask for help opening items, they are really, really nice. They don't just demand things or shake the thing at you to open it. They're really great kids this year. Bravo, kindergartner!
That's
love it.
Awesome.
Who's got one?
I got one.
Okay, go, Miss Cook.
From Ms. Flickinger, she wants a shout out to Brendan Werner and Weston Rigdon for being extra math warriors this week. They diligently completed extra math every day this week without reminders. And another shout out to Dylan Schlega and Miss Risha for continuing to be our primary and on the spot techies. They were extra great support to the class. All right.
Awesome. Nice. Awesome. Miss Munchko?
Yes, I got one from Miss Sewell. That's where my table is full of stuff. First of all, she wants to acknowledge 100% attendance in the lovely Miss D'Amico's class and Miss Serio's class.
Yay.
And then Miss Dawson's for 2 weeks in a row of 100%. Miss Cook's for four in a row of 100%. And Miss Yekstad's 9 Woo! In a row. And then she has a gentle reminder for her physical education students next week. All right. If you didn't have one this week, you need a balloon or maybe a lightweight ball, balloon. See that? There we go. A ball. And you need to implement some implementation things. So she said things like a spatula or a spoon or a paper plate. Oh, that's over there. I can't reach it. Or a frisbee. So that's from the lovely Mrs. Sewell. And this is for Kendall, because Kendall, from a former retriever, I think she's in college. She's watching. So.
Okay. Thank you, Miss Sewell. Miss Yexat wants to congratulate Ava Cuneo, Emily Schultz, for completing the Patriot program. Yeah.
Oh, awesome. And gotta wave the flag for that. That's right.
And Chase Harward and Haley Cole for all of their hard work. They both had a great transition back to school and are doing an excellent job. Keep it up, Yexstadians.
Yep. Well done, especially with the Patriot program. That's awesome. I got a message hot off the press from Mr. Stefanik, who wants to give a shout out to these following wonderful students of the week. The handsome Bennett Lubinsky, the wonderful Lane Van Slyke, and the lovely Jacqueline Wagner. From your Mr. Stefanik, good job, boys and girls, student of the week.
Yep. Ms. Dawson's class wants to congratulate David Rhodes and Brianna Critero for being the first students in her class to complete the Kindergarten Patriot program. Nice job, guys.
Woo-hoo.
And Ms. Schnicker wants to congratulate Adeline Vakovsky and Lucas Contagorgios.
Awesome.
They're great writers, and Lucas has been working super hard on his math, so excellent job.
I have another one.
Fire.
From Ms. Hackett, she would like to recognize the paras in her room, Ms. Hildebrandt, Miss Daly, Miss Lechner, and Miss Allen. She wants to thank them for their hard work, positive attitude, and willingness to do anything they are asked. Aside from all the work they do in their classroom, these ladies are helping other teachers in the pod, cutting materials, laminating, making copies. She said she feels blessed and thankful for them.
Great job, ladies. Excellent work. Miss Cuneo's class, her student of the week is Cameron Wallace. He's a star student in all subjects, always trying to do his best, showing on-task behavior and following directions. Cameron, you're working very hard. Keep it up. What a positive attitude.
Awesome.
And Miss Reinhardt sent me her Patriot list, and they are Riley Dawson, Ava Heath, Fletcher King, Zach Kelly, the CSER, Leszewski, Lucas Lundquist, and Rakaya Saeed. Yes, way to go, Patriots. Thank you, Miss Reinhardt.
That's awesome.
Anybody with anybody else?
I do have Yexstat, unless someone else does.
I got her.
You got her? All right, take it away.
All right. Okie dokie. Well, I think it's time for...
I got Miss... Did you say Miss Yexstat's class?
You did them.
Yes. Oh, you did two of them already?
We did them.
How did I miss that? Sorry. Whoops.
Okay. All righty. Well, let's how about some Maryland ladies, some women's history.
All right. Whatever you bring up, I am so ready for these wonderful women. Three of them are like math.
I noticed that this week.
Yeah, huge with their forward thinking for women. So the first one we have there.
Let's do the math one first. How about
that? Okay. All right. So this one is the lovely Elizabeth. I love her outfit. Elizabeth Smith Friedman here. Now, she is known, girls and boys, everybody, as a code breaker for the U.S. government during World War I. She studied English literature instead of math in college, but, listen up, her studies helped her find common patterns of letters and words in several languages. And with that, she was able to crack codes during WW1 that saved many lives. And despite being a woman, I mean, she was invaluable, and then she was in high demand later on for World War II and actually cracking codes of criminals. So that's
amazing.
Looks like a spy. That's pretty cool. We got to have a movie about her.
Yeah,
that sounds like a fun job, too.
Yeah. All right. These girls are the cyber code twins. They got cool names, America and Penelope. And they really came up, they're from California, and they didn't have a lot of any access actually to technology until their mom took a computer class. And then they were learning from that, and they were so inspired. They were hooked on transforming technology. So the two big vocabulary words for them is cryptocurrency. Ooh. It's a digital currency, yes, encrypted for security purposes. And the other big word was blockchain, that allows for digital currency to be shared but not copied. So it's a way to make things done safer and more securely, which ends up saving lives and money. You know,
yeah, I guess we'll have to have Mr. Seister explain all that arcane shenanigans to us.
Yeah, I looked at that for a while. That's a lot. That's pretty deep. I mean,
this one, though?
Woohoo! All right, Maria Callender, even though she's not with us, technically she is in the house.
We Let's got see.
Maria Callender pie in the house.
Marie Callender, yeah.
I did not know. I mean, I've been a big fan of her chicken pot pies. I did not realize she made dessert pies. So I'm this morning sampling for the first time ever. Yes. Maria. So I got to take a bite. Oh, there you go. Mm. Oh my God. It's so good. It's so good.
All right. It's got eggs in it, I'm sure, somewhere.
It's amazing. So, she moved with her family and she was looking for a better life. And when she got married, when she was working, she worked for a local deli. And then when her boss asked her to make pies, the oven at the deli didn't work. So she started making pies at home with her mom. Later on, when she got married, she opened up her pie shop. I thought this was kind of cool, you know, because I've never been out to LA, but she's from Long Beach, California, and she and her husband sold the family car to get money to start their first own business making these pies, and then officially went into business in 1964, okay, for the very first pie shop. So eventually, her son has taken over. She passed away in 1995, but her business, a small business, has grown to $90 million, sold billions worth of pies and other in restaurants and groceries.
That is
she's
awesome.
Just a small lady.
It's an entrepreneur, amazing entrepreneur.
Yes, and the math part too was her counting and measuring, because you could buy a slice. You didn't always have to buy a whole pie. But again, so she did a lot of math with that too.
Wow.
Just saying.
Thank you, Miss Munchko. Well, Miss Cook, I think that this kind of links up to your leader and me today.
It makes me think of so many things that we can relate to the habits.
Yep.
So this week on our leader and me page, Jenny and Chris tell us more about how we find our voice. And that's habit 8, finding your voice. Finding your voice means helping others, contributing, and making a difference by using our talents, passions, and conscience where there is a need. That made me think about so many of these amazing women that Ms. Munchko has been telling us about, and also some of the civil rights leaders that we talked about last month.
Mm-hmm.
These women use their talents and their passions to make a difference where they saw a need. If you think about the word conscience, you might be able to relate that to places in the world where you see injustice. If you think something seems unfair to a group of people, you might label that injustice. You might be able to use your voice to change things that seem unfair to you. Your conscience tells you when something is wrong. That is when you take advantage of your talents and passions to make a difference. If you know a retriever who has found their voice, we want to hear about them. So please send me a message.
I got one for you, Miss Cook. You.
Aw, thanks, Mr. Hamilton.
Yeah, that's awesome, Miss Cook. I love it.
Well said. All right, guys. Well, you keep your eyes out. Anybody who knows that there's a problem they want to solve and they start working for it, let us know about it.
Hey, I already have a retriever, a fifth grade retriever in mind who uses her voice. And I'm going to reach out to her and see if she wants to come on the show next week.
Sounds good.
I love that. That would be excellent.
Well, Miss Munchko, speaking of voices, did some of our retrievers send you some jokes this week?
Yes, they did.
Oh, boy.
I got some big jokes from retrievers.
Oh, no.
And that from from what, Clover and Barney? Well, since it's almost spring break, we have Hippity and Hoppity here to share the jokes from our lovely retrievers.
Oh my.
Yes, oh my, yes indeed. All right, first one's from Lydia Morris, okay? All right, what's going on, Hippity? All right, what do you call an alligator wearing a vest? I don't know, Hippity, what do you call an alligator wearing a vest? An investigator! that's a good one.
Investigator, oh boy.
Investigator, I don't have one on. This next one is from Cheechy. All right.
The Cheech.
Yep, the Cheech. Hey, why do we tell actors to break a leg? I don't know, Hoppity. Why do we tell actors to break a leg? Because they need a cast.
Oh.
That's a good one. Okay. All right. I've got two more. One from a student and one from a favorite lady of mine.
Go for it.
All right, Hippity's going on. This is from Matvi. Why did the turkey cross the road? I don't know, Hippity, why did the turkey cross the road? To prove he wasn't chicken.
That was a little lame.
All right, Matvi.
All right, last one of the day. Okay, and this, in honor of Marie Callender, we have a cooking joke. What does the baking soda say when he gets sad? I don't know. What does the baking soda say when he gets sad? I'm soda pressed. Soda press.
Oh, all right.
I probably should have bought some baking soda. I forgot something here. I had so many quotes, some deep quotes, but I'm going to go, believe it or not, with one that's simple, again, from my favorite Sister Jean, okay?
Wait,
Sister Jean.
Real quick before you go, did you tell us about how the Lady Terps did?
Oh, okay. Well, real quick update. Another famous lady. I did not do that, so I'm so excited for her.
I was wondering.
Miss Brenda Freeze, all right, she's been the Maryland women's coach for 18 years. However, out of these 18 years, all right, she has won 3 Final Fours, 12 conference titles, and a national championship. She's balanced a very strong work ethic with a fun friend family environment. And she was also the only one of 6 coaches to win a championship and be a parent. One of her championships, she gave birth like in the middle of one of her most successful
right there on the court?
Not there. I mean, but not that far away. But I love how she's just incorporated both, you know, the positive attitude, her passion, and combined the education, the work ethic. And they're playing. It was funny. I was in the shower and I was screaming. Like WBL has those questions, those Friday questions. Mm. And one of them was, who are the Maryland Women's Terps playing this Sunday? And I'm screaming in the shower, Texas, Texas. The guy didn't know. So they're playing the Texas Longhorns. But they are just going up and up. So go,
nice.
Maryland Terps.
Go, indeed.
All right, so we got to cheer for him.
Yeah. So, okay. All right, and our quote back to Sister Jean, 101-year-old Sister Jean, okay,
yeah.
Who keeps on trucking. Okay, I love this one. Okay, it is better to wear out than rust out.
Very good.
Yes, that's
song
awesome.
That's heard.
Yeah. So.
Thank you, Miss Munchkin.
Namaste. Yep.
All right. Well, changes in the wind. We've got spring right around the corner. Spring break coming 4 days a week on its way. And like with all changes that our teachers and our students and our families have had to grapple with since last spring, we've got another set of unique challenges ahead of us as we drive towards the end of the year. But like with all changes that together we've tackled as a team, this one we're going to keep rolling with too. And so that's our Rockin' Retrievers number 2 for you today. I hope you enjoy the show and have a great weekend.
Love the song.